वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम अगेन टू माय न्यू लेक्चर। आई एम मोहम्मद तनवीर अहमद, लेक्चरर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग, वर्ल्ड यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ बांग्लादेश। आउटलाइन ऑफ द लेक्चर। इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द थ्योरी ऑफ सेप्टिक टैंक एंड हियर इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस द डिजाइन प्रोसीड्यूर ऑफ सेप्टिक टैंक एंड हियर वी विल ऑल्सो perform a design example of septic tank. Treatment and disposal of sludge and scum. When tank is covered by 2/3 of its volume, then sludge and scum need to be cleaned. As septic tank effluent consist of pathogenic microorganisms, so cleaning must be done with caution. Normally, a septic tank usually discharged in every 2 to 5 years. In some countries, septic tank effluents used as soil conditioner to improve soil and also as food for fish. Disposal of septic tank effluent. As we know, septic tank partially treated the effluent into the septic tank, so septic tank effluent will not be discharged in open surface freely. It needs some pre-treatment or have to be discharged in a controlled way so that no pathogenic organisms can spread any further way. Septic tank effluent can be disposed into a subsurface soil absorption, and it is usually the best method. Subsurface exploration means to store the effluent into the soil but from a reasonable distance from the groundwater table to prevent groundwater from contamination. Generally, there are three types of subsurface soil absorption. First one is absorption trenches, then second one is absorption pits or shockwave pits. These are common in our countries. The last one is disposal to nearby sewage systems, and it is commonly known as SBS system. Here, this is the total system of a septic tank. Excreta from the toilet will come into the septic tank through this inlet pipe. Here, after some digestion, the effluent will be discharged through this pipe, and generally effluent can be discharged by these two systems. One is shockwave, and here in the shockwave the liquid waste with excreta will digest aerobically and mixed with the soil. And the other option is small bore sewage system, and with this small bore sewage system the effluent water or effluent solids directly enters into the main sewer in the road, and it is the and this water or this waste is treated somewhere in the treatment system. And this is the common practice or the total description of the septic tank. Let's see the design procedure of septic tank. First item is scum storage. Scum is the lightweight particles that will store in the top of the septic tank, and scums normally accumulate 30 to 40% at a rate to sludge accumulates. That means scum will be 30 to 40% of the sludge, and sludge is the particles that will settle at the bottom of the tank. If we see the picture of the tank, we'll clear it. This is the scum storage, and it is the top, and it is in the top of the septic tank, and it is the sludge storage zone which is at the bottom of the tank. So this storage will be 30 to 40% of the sludge storage. So we will take the maximum value 40%, and volume of scum will be 40% of sludge, that means 0.4 of sludge volume of, that means VSC is the volume of scum and VSL equal to volume of sludge, that means scum volume will be 40% of sludge volume. The second item is sedimentation. First we need to calculate the time required for sedimentation. From this equation we can easily calculate the time required to sediment in the septic tank. Here TH is the minimum mean hydraulic retention time and will be in days. P is the contribution population, that means the number of people or number of population uses that septic tank. Q is the wastewater flow per person per liter per person per liter per day. And the value of TH, that means this value should not be less than 0.2 days. That means it will always be greater than 0.2 days. From this equation, we can say that if the number of population P increases, the time for sedimentation will decreases. So how it is possible if more persons uses this tank and sedimentation time will decreases? An example I can say that as more person will use the latrine, the more will be the excreta load in sedimentation tank, and as a result the density of the sludge in the sedimentation tank will also increase. As the density of the sludge will increase, they will sediment early and thus reducing the time to sediment, and this is the reason for that the number of persons, more the number of persons uses the tank, the time will decreases. Then the volume of sedimentation tank we can calculate using this equation, and here P is the population, number of population uses the tank, Q equal to wastewater flow per person per liter per day, and TH is the time required for sedimentation, and this 10 to the power minus 3 is to convert this item from liter to meter cube. As Q is in liter, the total item will be in liter, and we know 1000 liter equal to 1 meter cube. So this 10 to the power minus 3 terms here is to convert this liter into meter cube. So the volume of BAs will be in meter cube. Then we have to calculate the digestion time of the sludge, and we can calculate the time for digestion by these two equation, and it depends, we can see it depends only in this term T, and here T is the temperature in degree Celsius. We can use any one of these two formula to calculate the digestion time. Then the volume of sludge can be calculated using this formula. Here the volume of fresh sludge is assumed 1 liter per person per day. This is the volume of fresh sludge, and this fresh sludge digested in TD days, as we have seen that digestion takes place in TD days or TD times. So after TD times, this 1 liter per 1 liter fresh sludge digested, and the digested volume stands 0.5 liter per capita per day. That means digestion rate is 50%. So the volume VD equal to 0.5 into 10 to the power minus 3 into PTD. P is the person uses the tank, TD is the time required to digestion. That means this time 10 to the power minus 3 is to convert this meter this item from liter to meter cube, and 0.5 is as the fresh slush digested only 0.5, so this item is multiplied here with this equation. We will just need to remember this formula to calculate the volume VD. And then slush storage. For slush storage, we need a definite volume, and for slush volume, it is depends on two factors. One is accumulation rate, that means C, unit will be in meter cube per person per year, and other item is the number of years for desludging. And this is the same formula as the simple pit latrine. Let's see the formula, and this is the formula for slush storage volume, C into P into N. Here P is the number of person, N is the number of desludging year, and C is the solid accumulation rate. And here C is 0.06 meter cube per person per year. When N will be less than 5, N that means number of desludging year is less than 5. And C will be 0.04 meter cube per person per year when N will be greater than 5. N means year. That means if when year of desludging will be greater than 5, and then C will be 0.04. And then overall design capacity, that means overall volume, will be the sum of all volume we have seen in our previous slides. That means scum volume, sedimentation volume, digestion volume, and this desludge volume. A sedimentation tank has 4 zones, so we have to add these 4 types of volume in this design steps. We have calculated VSC, VAS, VD, and VSL. By summing these 4 items, we will get the total volume. And as we know, VSC equal to 40% of VSL, that means 0.4 VSL. From here, in equation 1, VSC equal to 0.4 VSL. So we will replace this value here, and the total volume stands VAS plus VD plus 1.4 VSL. So using this equation, we can calculate the overall volume of the sedimentation tank. Now clear space depth. Clear space depth means this depth, that means sedimentation zone depth. Another name of this zone is clear space depth. This clear space depth, that means sedimentation zone depth, it depends on these two items, scum clear depth and slush clear depth. By summing these two clear depth, we can calculate the sedimentation zone depth, that means clear space depth. Here the submerged scum clear depth is the distance between the underside of the scum layer and the bottom of the outlet T, and should be at least 75 mm. That means submerged scum clear depth, that means scum clear depth, will be at least 75 mm. And this depth is from the under layer of the scum to the bottom of the outlet T. That means from this position is scum depth, bottom of the scum depth to the bottom of the outlet T. This space is the clear space of scum storage zone. The slush clear depth, that means this depth, slush clear depth, is the distance between the top of the slush layer to the bottom of the outlet T. Top of the slush layer to the bottom of the outlet T. If we see the figure, and this is the top of the slush layer and this is the bottom of the outlet T. That means from here to here, this distance is the slush clear depth. And we can calculate the slush clear depth using this equation, DSC, that means depth of scum clear depth. that depth of slash clear depth. Here A equal to cross sectional area of the tank, and this depth should be minimum 0.3 meter. That means minimum value should be 0.3 meter. Thus the minimum total clear space calculated as 0.075 plus DSC, minimum total clear space. Total clear space, as here said, total clear space is the sum of submerged cam depth and slash clear depth. Submerged cam clear depth minimum is 70 millimeter, that means 0.075 meter, and slash clear depth is 0.3 meter minimum. If we use minimum depth, we will get the minimum total clear space 0.075 plus 0.3 meter or DSC. This is the minimum clear space, and this value must compared with the VH by A, this sedimentation depth value. This value must compared with the depth of this value and taken whichever is greater. VH by A, what is VH by A? VH is the depth of the volume of the sedimentation zone. VH is the volume of the sedimentation zone. Yes, here we can see VH is the volume of sedimentation zone. If we divided this volume by area, we will get the depth of sedimentation zone. So these two depth will be compared and the larger one will be taken. Now let's design a septic tank. See the question. Design a septic tank for a family of 10 persons. That means 10 persons will be use this septic tank, and the discharging intervals is 6 years. That means every 6 years the tank will be discharged or emptied. Average wastewater flow is 90 liters per capita per day. That means this is the value of small q, 90 liters per capita per day. The soil is silty loam with a long term infiltration rate of 20 liter per meter square per day. This is the value of I, long term infiltration rate. This is the solution. First we have picked out the data from the question. Here wastewater flow rate q equal to 90 liter per capita per day. From this is here from the question. Design period or discharging period n equal to 6 years from here in this question. Infiltration rate I, 20 liter per meter square per day. As the sedimentation tank is the composition of 4 items, that means sedimentation zone, digestion zone, sludge zone, and is cum storage zone. So if we can calculate the volume of this 4 zone, we have calculated the volume of total septic tank. Once we have calculated the volume of the septic tank, then we need to calculate the depth of the tank. Let's see the diagram of the sedimentation septic tank. A septic tank comprises these 4 zones. So the calculation of the volume of these 4 zones means the calculation of the total volume of the septic tank, and the depth of these 4 items will comprises the total depth of the septic tank. First we will calculate the volume for sedimentation. Here volume for sedimentation VH is equal to this equation, and this is stated in design steps. Let's see the design step. This is the volume for sedimentation tank, equation number 3. Here the unknown items are 3, P, Q and TH. Let's again see the design. Here P is 10, as the 10 person is using this tank. Here is stated in this question, 10 person using this tank. Q equal to 90 liter per capita per day. This is also stated in the question, Q equal to 90 liter per capita per day. TH, TS is the time required for sedimentation, and it will be calculated using this equation, and this equation has also stated in our design steps. Here, by replacing the value of P and Q, we can calculate the value of TS. P is 10 and Q is 90, so the value of TS stands 0.61 day, whichever is greater than 0.2 day. As there was a limitation that the value of TA should not be less than 2 days. Let's see the limitation. Yes, that is the equation for to calculate TA, and here the limitation that the value of TA used should not be less than 0.2 days. That means minimum time TA will be 0.2 days. And here our calculated time is 0.61 days, which is greater than 2. So we will use TA is equal to 0.61 days. And replacing this value in equation of VA is the total volume of sedimentation stands 0.55 meter cube. Now we need to calculate the volume for digestion VD. Equation is 0.5 into 10 to the power minus 3 PTD. This equation is also stated in our design steps. Here the unknown value is P and TD. P is 10, TD will be calculated using this equation. There are two equations to calculate TD. Let's see the equation to calculate TD. To calculate TD, there are two equations, equation number 4 and equation number 5, and we have used equation number 5 to calculate TD. To calculate TD, we need this unknown value T. T means temperature, and there is no fixed data or said data in the question. And here we have assumed the value of T equal to 25 degrees Celsius. And using this value in this equation, we get TD equal to 42.32 day. And replacing this P and TD in equation to equation of VD, the volume of digestion VD stands 0.212 meter cube. Now our another term is calculation of sludge storage, so that means VSL. The sludge storage equation for sludge storage is normal as well as to the calculation of pit volume, and this is also stated in our design steps. Cp VSL equal to Cp into n. Here P equal to number of person uses the tank, that means 10, n equal to desludging air, that means 6, and C equal to, there are two limitations for C. Here C is greater than 5, that means as n is greater than 5, so C will be 0.04 meter cube per person per year. Let's see the limitations of using C. Here the limitations for using C. C will be 0.06 meter cube per person per year when desludging air n equal to n less than n will be less than 5, and C will be 0.04 meter cube per person per year when desludging period n will be greater than 6. As our desludging period n is greater than 5, so we need to use the value of C equal to 0.04 meter cube per person. So here we have used C equal to 0.04, and total sludge volume stands to 2.40 meter cube. Again, we need to calculate the last volume, scum storage, and we know the volume of scum storage is 40% of the sludge storage. Let's see. The volume of scum storage will be 40% or 0.4 of VSL. From this equation, we calculated VSC. So volume of VSC stands to 0.4 into VSL. VSC equal to VSL equal to 2.4 meter cube. So finally, VSC equal to 0.96 meter cube. Now the overall design capacity will be the sum of these four items: VSC, VSL, VH, and VD. If we sum these four items, we will get the overall design capacity, that means total volume of the tank, and our total volume extends to 4.12 meter cube. Now we need to calculate the depth of the tank, and to calculate the depth of the tank we need to assume the area or surface area of the tank, and there is no need there is no fixed provision to select the surface area. We can select the surface area based on our based on the availability of space in our construction site. But if we use a single compartment, there is a provision that the length of single compartment tank will be 3 times of the width. That means for single compartment, if the length is 3 meter, width will be 1 meter. And for two compartment tanks, there is no limitations, but there is a provision that the tank of rectangular shape or rectangular size is better than other shape. So we have to make the tank as rectangular by taking any surface area. So here assume surface area of the tank 3 meter cube, and using this 3 meter square we will calculate the area depth of the tank. So here we have calculated all the volume, and we have assumed surface area or area of the tank 3 meter square, and if we divided this volume with this area, we will easily get the depth. So here maximum depth of the slush, we need to calculate this items of this depth item, and first we have calculated the depth for slush. And here depth for slush DSL equal to volume of slush divided by area. Volume of slush equal to 2.4. Let's see, volume of slush equal to 2.4 meter cube and area is 3 meter square. So depth of slush stands to 0.8 meter. Similarly, maximum depth of submerged scum DSC will be volume of scum. DSC, that means depth of scum, volume of scum divided by area. And our volume of scum is 0.96 meter cube. So depth of submerged scum stands to 0.32 meter. Now scum clear depth equal to 0.075 meter. There is a provision for scum clear depth. Left see the provision in design steps. Here the submerged scum clear depth, that means scum clear depth is the distance between the underside of the scum layer and the bottom of the outlet T, and should be at least 75 millimeter. That means scum clear depth should be at least 75 millimeter, and if we convert this 75 into meter, we will get 0.075 meter. And from here, we picked this value. So scum clear depth is 0.075 meter. Now slush clear depth, there is an equation to calculate the scum clear depth, and the equation is 0.82 minus 0.26a. Here a is the area in meter square, and this value will be equal and greater than 0.3 meter. Using A as 3, we will get slush clear depth is 0.04 meter. And as this value is less than 0.3 meter, so we will use 0.3 meter because the minimum value of slush clear depth will be 0.3 meter. So adopted slush clear depth is 0.3 meter. Let's see these assumptions and equations in the design step. Here this was the equation to calculate the depth of slush clear depth, and here the minimum value is 0.3 meter. So we have to check this depth with this minimum value, and the larger value will be used. Now the minimum total clear space, that means that space, sedimentation zone space, the or sedimentation zone depth will be 0.075 meter plus DSC. DSC means 0.3 meter. So by summing these two items, 0.3 meter, that means value of DSC, or and 0.075 meter, we will get the total clear space, that means sedimentation zone space. So total clear space stands 0.3, this value, and 0.075 meter, this is scum clear depth, and it stands to 0.375 meter. Now we need to calculate the depth for sedimentation. Actually, this is the depth for sedimentation, and we have also calculated the volume for sedimentation, and from that volume we can calculate the depth for sedimentation, and we need to calculate that depth. And the depth required for sedimentation is volume of sedimentation divided by area. Volume of sedimentation was 0.55 meter cube. And here the depth for sedimentation required is 0.183 meter. We will now compare these two values, total clear space and depth for sedimentation. And the greater depth will be taken. As the greater depth is 0.375 meter, so our required depth will be 0.375 meter, the greater one. Now, by summing this all this depth, we will get the total depth of the tank. Here, the total effective depth equal to clear space depth plus DSL plus DSC. Here, clear space depth equal to 0.375 meter. As clear space depth equal to 0.375 meter, DSL equal to 0.8 and DSC equal to 0.32 meter. DSL equal to 0.8 and DSC equal to 0.32 meter, and total depth extends to 1.5 meter. So suitable internal dimension or internal dimension of the sedimentation tank will be 1 into 3, and this is the surface area, as we have taken 3 meter square as the area of the tank. Here 1 is width and 3 is length of the tank, and depth of the tank is 1.5 meter. So total volume of the tank extends to 4.5 meter cube, and our overall volume was 4.12 meter cube, and finally our design volume will be 4.5 meter cube. If we use two compartment, then the volume of first compartment will be twice that of the total volume. Here total volume V is 4.5 meter cube, so first compartment volume will be 3 meter cube, and the second compartment volume will be one third of the total volume. Here total volume equal to 4.5 meter cube, and the volume of second compartment stands 1.5 meter cube. And this equation was also discussed in our last lecture while discussing about the design procedure or design steps of septic tank. So finally we have designed our required septic tank dimension. Dimension will be 1 into 3 into 5 meter, and if we use two compartment, the first compartment will be 3 meter cube, second compartment will be 1.5 meter cube. This is the design of sedimentation tank, and with the sedimentation tank we need to design a shokwe tank. And how to design a shokwe tank, we will discuss or design this in our next lecture. So this is the end of our today's lecture. Thank you everyone.